Hi everyone, Dan here at Fanatic. Now, if you've watched any of my bike check videos, you'll know that I've been running code RSCs for a very long time. So it might surprise you that I'd like to talk to you about the Haze Dominion brake. This is actually a brake that was released in 2018, and it sort of slipped past us for a long time, but my coworker Nick has been running them on his Stump Jumper Evo, and he really thinks they're just the best thing out there. He urged us to take another look, so we did. Now, Haze was a force in hydraulic brakes for a very long time. The Haze 9, the Haze Mag, everybody wanted these brakes, I know I did. And then they kind of faded into the background for a while. So when they started the development of the Dominion, they took a step back and they started from scratch. They said, what does a mountain bike brake today really need? Through a lot of testing, data acquisition, and feedback from riders, they found that lever feel was hugely important, almost more so than the amount of stopping power. Any brake can stop you these days, but how does the lever feel? It has a huge role in how confident you feel on your bike and how fast you can go. So they did a lot of things here to make this lever feel extremely lightweight. Things like sealed bearings here in the lever body on which the lever pivots, and then a wholly redesigned master cylinder. That's the piston that pushes fluid through to the caliper. It slides on a glide ring, and then the ratio of the size of that piston to the pistons down here is worked so that this is an extremely low pressure system. It requires seals that don't need to be as tight fitting as other brakes, and again results in this very lightweight feel. Other things: mountain bikes, you crash, you throw your bike at a tree, it happens, but you don't want things to break when you do. So they've moved the reach adjust, that's the knob that controls how far away the lever sits from your handlebar, they moved that into this dial here on the lever itself instead of the protruding knob that you'll see on SRAM and Shimano brakes. Again, if you crash, it's far less likely to break off. Also, one thing I've noticed is that they use this two bolt clamping system, which makes it really easy to tighten this the perfect amount that in a crash it will rotate around the bar, but the rest of the time it'll stay exactly where you want it. So, moving down from this gorgeous lever body, you have a Kevlar reinforced hose, especially on the rear brake. That's important to prevent a mushy feel when the hose can expand and contract. That leads to a poor lever feel at the handlebar, down to an extremely stiff caliper. One thing they've done on this retention bolt, this pad retention bolt, that's actually structural, so it helps stiffen the caliper when the pistons are pushing in against that rotor. Other really handy items are these two little grub screws on the tabs that attach your caliper to the frame. That allows you to screw your brake bolts down, your caliper bolts, and then screw these in just enough to move the caliper just so it won't rub on that rotor. On other calipers that can take quite a bit of finicky adjustments, but on these it's a breeze. You'll see two bleed ports on this caliper, which is unusual. I've never seen it before, but it allows you to do essentially what we often do on our lever, which is a top bleed. We're only bleeding the lever and not worrying about the caliper. Now you can do the same thing down here and bleed this independently of the lever. You put two syringes on there and circulate fluid through the caliper and nothing else. Other really cool features are the rotors for these, the D-series rotors, a little bit thicker than other rotors out there. That helps keep cooling to a maximum, brake fade to a minimum. And they've actually cut those out so that they say it reduces squealing to a minimum, which, especially out here in the wet, is kind of a pain in the butt when your brakes are squawking all the time. Now, I told you my coworker Nick has been running these, and I asked him what he liked about it. He did say you get some squeal in the wet, but he said that the modulation and power control of these brakes was just sort of hands down the best he's experienced. Again, the really lightweight feel and the degree to which you can get the wheel to stop if you want, or just back off a hair and get it to start rolling again under control. Really good power gradient. These brakes do ship with two sets of pads, which is awesome. They come installed with the organic pads or semi-metallic. They also include a set of metallic brake pads, which if you're in wet conditions, I like these. If you really are looking for stopping power, I would run the metallic pads, but it's nice that they include both. You do need to purchase rotors separately. They come in 180 or 203 mil rotors. And if you're gonna bleed these, you'll need .5.1 or .4 fluid. Same thing for SRAM brakes and a number of others out there. Very easy to find. Now, if you have any questions about these awesome brakes, or if you wanna pick a setup, you know where to find us, fanaticbike.com. You can also leave us a comment below. We'll get back to you. Or give us a shout at 844-FANATIC. That's 1-844-326-2845. Email us at sales@fanaticbike.com. Thanks for watching, y'all. We'll see you next time. Cool. We're done.